what are the features or finishes that you hear requested, or do you suggest your clients focus on healthy environments when designing a new home, kitchen, bathroom, or other space?
So, yeah, I mean, we try to build everybody a healthy home, and that means a lot of different things to different people. You know, a lot of spaces that people want are, exercise spaces, meditation rooms, or, some kind of quiet space, spas or kind of home spaces like that. There's a lot of spaces that can people use to relax and kind of decompress from kind of the crazy world we're in. In terms of, building materials, we try to use natural materials. If we're doing plywood boxes, we're specifying no formaldehyde in the plywood, low VOC finishes, and things like that to kind of help with the off-gassing. The houses we're doing now are super tight and super insulated, so you need ERVs to exchange and bring in fresh air and do it in a energy efficient kind of way. And then there's lots of our designs are very connected to the sites and the indoor outdoor living. People like being outdoors and using their property to live in, outdoor rooms and outdoor spaces in addition to the things inside the house. And some of the more innovative things that I'm starting to see come down the line are things like LED lights that are tied to circadian rhythm, and so the color temperature of the light will change over the course of the day, and so it'll be warm in the morning and warm at night and more tied to daylight colors. It tends to be pretty, there's some stuff standard. Everybody wants a good security system, cameras. Nobody did until 10 years ago. Now everybody's got cameras, and there's so many layers of things that people want, but it's got to be easy, it's got to be hassle free, and a lot of people say they don't want it, but then, oh, by the way, I'll take that, and put one of those in, and by the time you're done, there's enough stuff there. So I think it's just going to keep, we're increasingly such a mobile society, and more things are going to be hooked up to the web and monitored and accessed and that. But I also think, I hope that this movement toward green and sustainable houses is something that really kicks in with our awareness of global warming. And, it's a topic that is getting discussed more. I mean, concrete is extremely carbon intensive, so is steel. Bill Gates just had a book on the climate crisis and mentioned some of the things they're working on, like concrete. They're going to do carbon capture and sink it into concrete, and the concrete can actually become a sink, of that. So there's, picking, organic, natural materials that aren't sourced from, halfway around the planet and things. So I think the design industry, it's starting to be on everybody's radar, and a lot of clients, they don't come and say, hey, do this for me, but if you mention it along the way and it's kind of the right thing and it's not too big of a deal and it's not too much of a premium, a lot of times they will go for it. And as long as it's really well designed and beautiful, they'll often go for it. And then they'll feel really good about themselves because they did it. I think as a design community, it's really up to us to bring the topic up to our clients and give them, because these big houses are incredibly resource intensive. And so, the best thing we can do, the most sustainable house is one that already exists and that you save and you fix up. And one that's beautifully designed that's gonna last for 100 years, and that's what we try to do, and will be adaptable to the future. And so, I think that's going to be a bigger and bigger topic, and we'll all continue to become educated and learn what we can offer our clients.